Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back. My name is notiansans. This, of course, is Learn How to Edit Stuff. It's week 3 of quarantine. I shaved my head, but that doesn't matter. What does matter is today's lesson, which I am sourcing from you guys. That's right. If you join the Learn How to Edit Stuff Discord, today is your lucky day. If you haven't joined my Discord, there is a link in the video description below for you to come join. And today I am taking your requests from the tutorial requests channel on the Learn How to Edit Stuff Discord, and I'm showing you guys how to do it. Now, I picked 3 of your requests to go through today. The first request is from Ben Jutsu, who wants to know how to do this music video replicate style kind of thing. Oh, we're doing it today. Second request comes from Flay, who wants to know how to do this chat, instant message, text message effect. I do have another tutorial on my channel that covers this, but it is a cool effect, so we're gonna cover it again today. And request number 3 comes from Billy DeBongo, who wants to know how to do subtitles like Fitz Swagger or Soviet Womble on YouTube. I didn't know who either of those people were, but I went on YouTube, saw their videos, and they're just doing cool little subtitles that pop up as people are talking. So I'm gonna show you guys how to templatize that in After Effects or Premiere. It works both the same way, but those are the 3 things that we're gonna be covering today. So thank you for submitting. If you guys haven't joined the Discord yet, again, link in the video description below to join the Discord, submit a tutorial request, sit back, relax, have some fun, because we're jumping in right now. All right, guys, first up is the music video replicate effect. This is the example that was sent to me, and upon further investigation, this is fairly simple to break down. All of this was shot on a green screen, then keyed out, placed on a white background, and replicated in various ways. Then a 3D camera was added to the scene and keyframed to achieve the desired effect. To do this yourself, you're gonna need some green screen footage. Next, key out the green by using key light and spill suppression in After Effects. Now, I do have an in-depth video on my channel exactly how to do this process. If you guys need a refresher or you don't know how, I highly recommend watching it. Link in the video description below. Now, once you've keyed out the green, I recommend exporting the clip out of After Effects so your computer doesn't have to work as hard with all the chroma key stuff happening. For your settings, match exactly what I have here to achieve the highest quality. Export the clip, then re-import it back into After Effects. Once you've done that, make your layer 3D by clicking on the cube, change the view mode to 2 views horizontal, and start duplicating the layer and pulling on the Z-axis arrow for each duplicate. Eventually, you'll end up with a huge line of dancers kind of vanishing into the horizon. Next, add a 3D camera to After Effects. Then add a null object and name it Camera Control. Pick-whip the camera to the null object and make the null object 3D, then use position keyframes on the null object layer to animate your camera moving through the scene. Now set some camera position keyframes in your scene and you can start offsetting layers, change the way they animate in, and experiment with different types of animations. Now, just for clarity, adding a null object as a camera control gives you a little bit more safety with camera animations. This isn't a necessary step, but I do recommend doing it. Now, I understand that is a very basic explanation on how to do something that is kind of complicated. I totally understand, and I'm not gonna teach you guys how to do this exact effect one-to-one because I want you to understand the process that goes into it so you can do it yourself. I hope that makes a little bit of sense to you guys out there. Anyway, example number 2, these text message effects. Again, if you guys want a bit more in-depth tutorial on this effect, links are in the video description below to one of my previous videos. Now I'm gonna use this scene from the same music video with no animations in it to demo this for you guys. First, click on the clip that you're gonna animate for, go to the tracker menu and choose track camera. Once the camera has been tracked, find a cluster of points, right click on those points and choose create solid and camera. Now what you're gonna wanna do is click on that solid on your timeline, rotate it and make sure that it is facing towards the camera and not off to the side or some weird off angle. Next, you're gonna create your text message bubble and design. I'm just using simple shape layers and text, but you guys can make this however you want. Once you've designed your chat or text message or whatever, pick whip all parts of it to the main body shape. Now click your main shape layer and center your anchor point in the middle of the layer by hitting Control, Alt, and Home on your keyboard, or choosing Layer, Transform, Center Anchor Point. Now align your shape layer in the vertical and horizontal center of your composition using the Align tab. Just clicking on these 2 buttons right here in the middle will center it in your composition. All of the other elements should also center if they're pick whipped properly. Now select all the various layers of your design and pre-compose it by hitting Shift Control C on your keyboard or right clicking and going to pre-compose. Make your pre-comp 3D and copy and paste the position data from your solid to the position data of your pre-comp. Now you'll see that your pre-comp will kind of shrink down to the size of your solid. You can go ahead and delete that solid out of your timeline. We will not use it anymore. But now scale up your pre-comp to a decent size, and now your text should be tracked along with the camera. Now you can add some X rotation keyframes to have it swing into your scene or animate this however you want for the style that you're going for. You're gonna wanna repeat the exact same process for each shot in your music video. And last but not least, we have these fun gaming subtitles. Honestly, the most effective way to do this is to make your own presets in After Effects for a quick recall later. First, make a new text layer and design it however you want. Whatever font you want to use, whatever color, you want to use a stroke, no stroke, just kind of design the text however you want to design it. Next, center the anchor point on your text layer by hitting Ctrl, Alt, and Home on the keyboard, or going to Layer, Transform, Center, Anchor Point. Then you're going to align it with the horizontal and vertical center in your composition using the Align tab, again, hitting these two little middle buttons right here. Now, search your effects for the transform effect and drop that onto the text layer. In this example, I'm going to animate the scale from 100 to 110 and then back to 100 to make the text pop over the course of 4 frames. Don't forget to mess with the graph editor to smooth everything in your animations out. Get it to be exactly how you want it before we save it as a preset. Once you've done that, click on the transform effect in your effect controls, then go to Animation, Save Animation Preset. You're gonna wanna save it somewhere on your computer, like your Documents folder or somewhere that's easily accessible. Now, after you've done that, navigate to Program Files, Adobe, After Effects, Support Files, Presets, and make your own custom folder name in that folder. Once you've done that, you're gonna drag and drop the preset you made into your custom folder, then in After Effects, right-click on Effects and Presets and refresh the tab. Now your custom presets will be in that folder. You can now drag and drop that preset onto a new text layer to quickly animate all of your subtitles in the exact same way. You're always gonna wanna center your anchor point and center it in your composition before applying this preset. You can do this for a variety of animations using the transform property and build yourself a nice little bank of custom presets. You can also animate words on screen by masking the text and keyframing the mask path to reveal the words. Well, there it is, and there you have it, folks. 3 questions answered from the Learn How to Edit Stuff Discord. Hey, I'm proud of you for submitting those questions. Are you not in the Discord? Have you not submitted a question? Link in the video description below to join the Learn How to Edit Stuff Discord. There's also links in the channel to old video tutorials that go in-depth about a lot of the stuff that we talked about today in this video. So thank you for submitting the questions, thank you for joining the Discord, thank you for watching this video, and thank you for learning how to edit stuff. And if you haven't already, please, please, make sure you subscribe to the channel and also check out the last video that you missed. We do them here weekly at Learn How to Edit Stuff. Let me know what you want to learn and I'll do a video like this for you specifically. Join the Discord. Don't forget, subscribe, check out the last video that you missed, and I will see you next time. Quarantine haircut.